Imagine stepping back in time to a world where every note tells a story and every rhythm paints a picture. Welcome to the world of Lee Morgan's iconic album, The Sidewinder. And today we are taking a deep dive into this classic album. So grab a cup of tea, sit back, relax, and enjoy our video. But before you do this, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell. Thanks. The Sidewinder, recorded on December 21, 1963, at the famous Van Gelder Studio in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey, a studio synonymous with top-quality jazz recordings. Rudy Van Gelder, the legendary engineer, was instrumental in capturing the album's unique sound. His expertise in acoustics and recording technology played a crucial role in this session. The title track, The Sidewinder, became an unexpected hit, propelling the album to commercial success. The song's groove and infectious melody made it a staple on jukeboxes and radio stations. Its success helped revive Blue Note Records financially and brought Lee Morgan into the spotlight. Born on July 10, 1938, in Philadelphia, Lee Morgan was a prodigious talent from a young age. He quickly gained recognition for his distinctive trumpet playing. Joining Dizzy Gillespie's big band at 18, Morgan's career took off rapidly. His education in music was both formal and through real-world experience in Philadelphia's vibrant jazz scene. Before The Sidewinder, he had already made a name for himself with Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers. Now fast forward to May 2020, and the folks at Music Matters Jazz released this classic album as part of their Blue Note, the definitive vinyl reissue SRX series. Mastered from the original analog tapes by Kevin Gray and pressed on 180-gram vinyl at RTI, it offers an unparalleled listening experience for any jazz aficionado lucky enough to have this pressing in their collection. The SRX vinyl formula is a game changer. It's all about reducing noise, enhancing clarity, and bringing the listener closer to the original studio sound. This innovative formula has set a new standard in vinyl record manufacturing. Now for the music. The title track, The Sidewinder, is a masterclass in hard bop composition. Lee Morgan's trumpet sets the tone with a bluesy melody. Joe Henderson's tenor adds depth and complexity with his robust solos. The rhythm section, featuring Barry Harris on piano, Bob Cranshaw on bass, and Billy Higgins on drums, provides a groovy and compelling backdrop. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Up next is the track Totem Pole, which is an energetic showcase of the band's talent. Morgan's trumpet and Henderson's tenor engage in a lively musical conversation, while Harris' piano anchors the track with rhythmic and harmonic support. Cranshaw and Higgins drive the piece forward with a vibrant rhythm. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Next, we have the track Hocus Pocus, which is a rhythmically intricate and lively composition. Morgan's trumpet takes the lead with inventive phrasing and high energy, while Henderson's tenor follows with a solo that weaves through the track's complex rhythms. The rhythm section creates a vibrant and tight foundation. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Thank you. Now for the musicians. Joe Henderson, a master of the tenor, brought his unique sound to the Sidewinder. His previous work with Kenny Dorham had already established him as a rising star in the jazz world. On this album, his robust and dark tone added depth and complexity to the tracks. Barry Harris, a renowned bebop pianist, contributed significantly to this album's sound. His background with Cannonball Adderley and other jazz greats influenced his playing on the Sidewinder. Harris provided a solid harmonic and rhythmic bass, allowing for the soloists to shine. Bob Cranshaw, known for his versatility, brought a distinctive bass sound to this album. His experience with Sonny Rollins and other jazz luminaries is evident in his playing. Cranshaw's bass lines on the Sidewinder are both supportive and inventive, adding a rhythmic complexity to the album. Billy Higgins was known for his innovative drumming from his work with Ornette Coleman. On the Sidewinder, his drumming is both subtle and dynamic, providing a solid foundation for the soloists. His cymbal work, especially on tracks like Hocus Pocus, adds a vibrant texture to the album. The Sidewinder remains a monumental album in jazz history. Its blend of hard bop and soulful melodies set a new standard for jazz recordings, and it is celebrated for its innovation and lasting impact on the genre. Today, the Blue Note Records Classic Vinyl Series reissue of The Sidewinder is still available for jazz aficionados. This reissue maintains the high standards of audio quality and craftsmanship associated with Blue Note. It offers a new generation of listeners the opportunity to experience this classic album in its full glory. I want to thank you for taking this deep dive into Lee Morgan's iconic album, The Sidewinder. But before you go, please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and ring that notification bell to stay current in the jazz vinyl world. Let's keep the legacy alive, one record at a time. Bye for now. If you are interested in more deep dives into the world of jazz vinyl, then click on this video right here, where we take you on a journey into Wayne Shorter's classic album, Adam's Apple.